Hello, welcome to any TVN channel. In this video I will show you how to build a NAS server with Hyper-V hypervisor that has multiple physical hard drives. To build a NAS server, you need to prepare at least one solid-state drive to install Windows operating system and two traditional hard drives to build a NAS server. You can add more hard drives if you want. If you find the video useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. On Windows operating system, open Disk Management and check if your computer has detected the hard drives or not. As you can see, the computer detected one solid-state drive and two traditional hard drives. Solid-state drive for Windows OS installation. In order for Hyper-V to connect directly to physical hard drives, you need to switch the status of traditional hard drives from online to offline. So two traditional hard drives are offline. Here I use two traditional hard drives with a capacity of 500 GB. To build a NAS server I use TrueNAS Core, an open source software. TrueNAS requires a minimum hardware configuration of 16 GB solid state drive. For virtual machines you only need 4 GB of RAM. So that you don't have to wait long, I have pre-downloaded the TrueNAS Core installer to my computer. Next you open Hyper-V hypervisor to build the NAS server. So that you can access the NAS server from your local network I create a new virtual switch. Virtual Switch Manager External create virtual switch. After creating a new virtual switch, create a new virtual machine. You name it however you want, I named the virtual machine NAS. The minimum RAM required by TrueNAS is 16 GB, but you can install with smaller RAM egg 4 GB or 8 GB. About the network connection, you choose the virtual switch you just created. With this configuration, other computers on your local network can access your NAS server. You only need a 16 GB virtual hard drive to install TrueNAS operating system. Next, browse to the TrueNAS installation file downloaded in the previous step. Your virtual machine does not have physical hard drives yet, so you will add them in the next step. Next, you add the physical hard drives to the virtual machine. You edit the virtual machine and add each new physical hard drive. Settings SCSI controller hard disk add. Physical hard disk. In the drop-down list will appear two physical hard drives that we have prepared. You add physical hard drives to your virtual machine in turn. As you can see, the virtual machine has two more physical hard drives. Because the virtual machine has physical hard drives, you have to disable the checkpoint feature. The preparation steps are done, now you install TrueNAS on the virtual machine. You start the virtual machine and install TrueNAS. As you can see, there are three hard drives. You install the operating system on a virtual hard drive of size 16 GB. You will be asked to create an admin password during TrueNAS installation. It will take about 5 minutes to install TrueNAS, which is pretty fast. After the installation is complete, disconnect the TrueNAS installation ISO file. It takes you a few more minutes to start the TrueNAS virtual machine. When the screen shows the IP address of the successful virtual machine, You open any browser and enter the virtual machine IP address to access TrueNAS's management page. Finally, check if TrueNAS detects two traditional hard drives. As you can see, the traditional hard drive has been detected. So I've introduced how to build a NAS server with Hypervisor with multiple physical hard drives. Thank you for watching. If it's useful, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel.